Welcome to Cryptocurrencies, the Future of Digital Money Show at PortfolioWealthGlobal.com. My name is Michelle Holliday. Today, we are welcoming back to the show Mr. Roger Veer. Roger is the CEO of Bitcoin.com. He is a crypto pioneer and a very successful investor in this space. He is definitely one of the most influential personalities within the community, and today he's coming to us from Switzerland. We're excited to have him here. Roger, welcome to the show. How are you today?
Thank you, Michelle. I'm glad to be back.
Oh, we're thrilled to have you here. It's exciting time. Roger, I want to start off the show off the top by giving everybody who might not be familiar with you an introduction into the scope of your activity within this sector. You are a pioneer investor in Bitcoin, but tell us about the startups that you have seeded, because many of them now make up the infrastructure of this industry.
Yeah, basically, I was the first person to, I was the first person in the entire world to start investing in this ecosystem. So the names that I provided the seed funding for that are now kind of commonplace are blockchain.com, kraken.com, bitpay.com, purse.io, a whole bunch of them. So and today I'm busy running bitcoin.com.
Yes, everything that's well known now, you tend to have had a sort of a hand in it. How do you choose your investments, especially when it was very, very new and just starting up?
I look for things that are actually useful. And if they're useful to real people in their real lives, then people are going to start using it. And it has to be significantly more useful than the alternatives that people have available to them currently. So when I saw Bitcoin, I knew it was more useful than banks. And when I saw Bitcoin Cash, I knew it was more useful than what people are calling Bitcoin today. So I'm really excited about Bitcoin Cash, but I'm excited about anything that works. If it's useful for people, they're going to use it. And the same is true for me.
I want to stay with the topic of Bitcoin Cash. For everyone who's not familiar with the difference between Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash, from your vantage point, is it actually a replacement for Bitcoin? And tell everybody about Bitcoin Cash, what exactly it is.
So from my vantage point, Bitcoin Cash has all the same economic characteristics that made me so excited about Bitcoin to begin with. And so from my point of view also, the thing that everybody's calling Bitcoin today no longer has those characteristics. So when you're investing in Bitcoin Cash today, it's just like investing in Bitcoin back in 2011, 12, 13, 14. And when you're investing in Bitcoin today, you're investing in some unproven economic model that I'm much, much more skeptical of, because the software developers behind Bitcoin today, they openly say that they want the transactions to be slow, expensive, and unreliable, whereas the Bitcoin Cash developers want the transactions to be fast, cheap, and reliable. And I don't think you have to be a Nobel Prize winning economist or a rocket scientist to figure out that fast, cheap, reliable payments are more useful to people than slow, expensive, and unreliable payments. So that's why I switched most of my time and effort and resources to promoting Bitcoin Cash today.
Really? That's so interesting, because as the CEO of Bitcoin.com, it's sort of a dichotomy. Where do you stand as far as Bitcoin goes?
I wish the Bitcoin project good luck, but it's not the project that I got excited about back in 2011. It's not the project that I started seeding with my money in the early days. That project today, the one that most closely resembles it, is today called Bitcoin Cash. And that's why, from my point of view, I'm promoting the exact same project today that I started promoting back in 2011. The only difference is that now it's called Bitcoin Cash, whereas previously it was just called Bitcoin. And the nice part about it, though, too, is Bitcoin Cash is only $200-something today, and it's 30-something times cheaper than what everyone's calling Bitcoin. Bitcoin isn't 30 times more likely to succeed than Bitcoin Cash, so it's like it's almost like you have a time machine to go and buy the version of Bitcoin that made Bitcoin popular to begin with. So, man, Bitcoin Cash has all sorts of amazing upside. The upside of Bitcoin, I don't think, is nearly as large. So as from an investor standpoint, I think it's smart to be much, much, much heavier on Bitcoin Cash than it is on Bitcoin, because fast, cheap, reliable payments versus slow, expensive, unreliable payments. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to figure out which one of those two is more likely to be popular in the long run.
It's so exciting, because it's like everybody has a second chance to jump in.
That's how I feel. And I'm spreading the word about that second chance today, just like I was spreading the word about the first chance back in 2011 about Bitcoin.
Exactly. Now, shifting gears just a little bit, you touched on the cost of cryptocurrencies, specifically Bitcoin, because relatively speaking, there are still very few people and very few institutions and corporations that are actually jumping in to utilize cryptocurrencies, even though it is far less expensive than fiat currencies. Talk to us about the actual use of cryptocurrencies within the real world and what actually has changed, Roger, as far as Bitcoin goes.
So I've been driving adoption of cryptocurrencies in the real world since day one. That was one of the things that made me so excited about BitPay, is because they enabled companies like Microsoft and Expedia and Tiger Direct and all these amazing companies to start accepting Bitcoin for payments. And then when the Bitcoin network intentionally became congested and the fees intentionally became high and the fees intentionally congested the entire network, those companies like Microsoft and like Expedia, they literally stopped accepting Bitcoin for payments. So we had negative merchant adoption. But today we're seeing more and more merchant adoption from Bitcoin Cash. There's literally more physical shops around the world accepting Bitcoin Cash today than there are accepting Bitcoin. And there's probably more websites accepting Bitcoin Cash today than there are Bitcoin. So I'm really, really bullish on the future of this, and I'm busy building the tools and the infrastructure to make Bitcoin Cash work as money from around the world. And, you know, Fortune 100 companies are taking notice. We just announced recently HTC, one of the premier cell phone manufacturers in the entire world. They're integrating our Bitcoin.com wallet directly into their smartphone. So when you buy a new HTC phone, you get a copy of the Bitcoin.com Bitcoin Cash wallet built right in. And we're working with other household names that every single person on the planet has heard of. We have exciting new partnerships coming from them that we'll be announcing in the future as well. So, and they're all working with us because they know Bitcoin Cash works right now, today, in real commerce for real people. And as much as I love Bitcoin and as much as it has a special place in my heart, the thing that's called Bitcoin today no longer works for real people in real commerce. And that's why people are switching to Bitcoin Cash all around the world. And any business that's looking to use a cryptocurrency, Bitcoin Cash is right at the top of their list because it works right now, today. You don't have to wait.
It's so interesting. I just want to stay on this topic. What changed? Who changed it? What's behind this change?
So what was behind this change is a bunch of people that didn't understand the underlying economic reasons that made Bitcoin popular to begin with. They came in and changed the economic code that made Bitcoin successful. They took a system that worked incredibly well with fast, cheap, reliable payments and turned it into one that's slow, expensive to use, and unreliable by imposing an artificial quota in the amount of block space that the miners can produce. And so Bitcoin Cash doesn't have that artificial quota. The Bitcoin BTC network does. So the miners are only allowed to produce 1 megabyte worth of block space every 10 minutes. And there's a little bit more nuance to that. Technically, it's maybe a little bit more than 1 megabyte, but that only allows for around 2,000 something transactions every 10 minutes, whereas the Bitcoin Cash network can produce up to 32 megabytes of block space every 10 minutes, and that can increase in the future. So BTC version of Bitcoin can do around 3 transactions a second. Bitcoin Cash right now today can do more than 100 transactions a second. If you're a business looking to use cryptocurrency, it's not hard to figure out which one of those is more scalable to your needs.
Wow. And in the $200 range right now, I mean, I can't emphasize this enough to our audience. Hello.
I think the last Bitcoin was in around $200 was way back in 2013. So this is a fantastic opportunity. And that's why I've even used some more of my own money earlier today to buy more Bitcoin Cash.
Excellent. Now, Roger, I know that you are very vocal against government constraints and taxes, and that you believe in individual freedom, which is part of the reason that you're so passionate about sovereign digital coins. From your personal perspective, is it more accurate to say that you're against the current behavior of world governments, or do you believe that we would actually be better off completely without their contribution at all?
I think both of those things are likely to be true. I'm absolutely certainly opposed to the behavior of world governments today when dropping bombs on people all around the world and putting up trade barriers to prevent people from trading with other people. That makes the entire world a poorer place as a result. As to whether or not would the world be a better place with no government whatsoever, I don't know. We've never been allowed to try it. There's always been governments. But I think we should start reducing the size of government, make it smaller and smaller and smaller. And if we get to all the way where there's no government and then it becomes a problem, we can always make some government again. But let's give it a try and see what happens. I'm totally in favor of giving it a try. Let's experiment and see what happens.
That's awesome. Because we can always bring it back. We know this.
That's right. We can always bring it back. And we know the damage caused by having too much government. I mean, look around the world. It's apparent to everybody, the damage and the destruction and death caused by having too much government. So let's limit that.
And it's extraordinary, just as a point, that politicians enter office, and then when they go to leave office or go to get reelected, it's like, well, what new laws did you propose? That's the measure of their success, of putting new laws, more constraints upon us. I think that
Yeah, you never hear them talking about repealing laws or reducing taxes. It's always what new ones about everything, and how can they run your life even more than they do now. But of course, each individual knows how to run their own life better than any politician in some far-off city could do it for them. So I'm in favor of individuals running their own lives, and that's why I love cryptocurrencies so much.
Absolutely. Now, in your opinion, how much government regulations of cryptocurrencies could impact this industry in the years to come?
So I have two answers to that question. So philosophically, all a regulation is a threat, right? It's a threat from a bunch of strangers saying that other people have to get their permission in order to engage in whatever sort of business. So philosophically, I don't think we need any of that at all whatsoever. It's crazy talk. From a more practical standpoint, we live in a world that has regulations and lawmakers and regulators and that sort of thing. And if you're running a business, you need to abide by what those people say. And so we want to have really clear, concise regulations, so it's very clear to the businessmen and the entrepreneurs what sort of regulations they need to abide by so they can go and run their business and not worry about having the rug pulled out from them under them tomorrow. And so there's my philosophical answer and my practical answer.
Exactly. I think clarification so that you don't build upon something that's going to disappear is extraordinarily important. Now, do you feel that a more rapid adoption pace for cryptos, that the only possible way for this to happen is for first the fiat currencies to implode in some way?
Well, it's not the only possible way, but I think getting massive adoption around the world of cryptocurrency to where everybody's using it for everything, from, you know, baby formula to diapers for old people, right? Everything from every age spectrum of every gender, every race, every nationality. If they're using cryptocurrency, and if we get them using cryptocurrency really quickly, it'll be too late for the politicians and the regulators to do anything to stop it. And we don't want to stop it. We want people to use cryptocurrency for everything because it makes the world a better place. It enables more free trade. It enables more financial sovereignty for individuals. It's a great thing for everybody. So I think absolutely the best strategy is to get to as many people using cryptocurrency in every aspect of their life as quickly as we possibly can. And it's up to all of us to help spread that adoption and help set up our friends and neighbors and family with cryptocurrency wallets and show them how to use it and show them how to save money with it online. It's up to us to spread the word.
Right. And that leads me into the user-friendly aspect of this. Now, do you sometimes get the feeling that as you're expressing yourself in terms of liberation of self, that society actually does not want this, that they're more comfortable with sort of customer service than they are in taking control of their own cryptocurrency, their own money with their own wallets and learning the technologies and so on and so forth. In other words, is this just attractive to a very small portion of society?
Well, I think everybody likes saving money, no matter what part of society they're from. And one of my favorite examples of that is a website called purse.io that allows you to save 20, 25, even 30% off every single purchase from Amazon by paying in Bitcoin Cash. So purse.io is that website. Save 20% on Amazon with Bitcoin Cash. So no matter what walk of life you're from, that should be pretty darn attractive to you. And I think society isn't one single person, though. It's made up of all sorts of, you know, millions of people all over the world with different wants and desires and wishes. And some people will love using cryptocurrency for everything, and other people maybe not so much. But that's the beauty of the free market, is everybody gets to have whatever it is that they're after. You know, Baskin Robbins has at least 31 flavors. Government is one size fits all. So I'm in favor of people having more choices, not less. And that's why I love the free market and cryptocurrencies, because there's thousands of them for people to choose from at this point.
That was a really great tip, that website. So it's purse.io, P-U-R-S-E.io.
Perfect.
Great. Perfect. Now, what crypto advancements have been made for the so-called unbankables, people that don't have bank accounts, don't have credit cards? There are many that fall into that category throughout the world. What kind of advancements are being made right now, and what have you watched happen over the past 2 years, say?
So just back in June of this year, so just a couple of months ago, we launched another website called local.bitcoin.com that allows anybody to buy or sell any amount of Bitcoin Cash with anyone for any payment method in any country. So you can buy and sell it in China, Russia, Venezuela, absolutely anywhere in any amount with any payment method with no KYC required. Bitcoin.com never touches the money, so we never ask you for any of your information whatsoever. So you can literally buy and sell Bitcoin Cash for cash in the mail, WeChat, Alipay, bank wire transfer. You can meet someone at Starbucks and they can hand you an envelope of cash, or in either direction, you can hand them an envelope of cash and they can send you Bitcoin Cash. And it's using this amazing platform that has what's called a self-custodial escrow, where the Bitcoin Cash is held in escrow, but it's not held in escrow by Bitcoin.com. It's held in escrow by the two people engaging in the trade. And nothing like that has ever been possible before the invention of cryptocurrencies. And this is live right now today, and people are using it all over the world to trade millions of dollars worth of Bitcoin Cash with no KYC required. So if you're a freelancer on the internet and someone pays you in Bitcoin Cash, but your local supermarket isn't accepting Bitcoin Cash directly, you can use this website to exchange it for the local currency and then go shopping at your local supermarket. So it's a really fantastic, powerful website available at local.bitcoin.com.
Local.bitcoin.com.
Perfect.
That is amazing. That's probably the best advancement I've heard in a long time, because it's the KYC. That's the nightmare. It's the know your client, jump this, jump that. And then you sit and wait for 2 months for them to get to your file to see if you...
And I have another really exciting development that we just launched maybe 2 weeks ago now. It's a tool on top of the Bitcoin Cash blockchain. There's now tokens. And we've built a tool so that any token holder anywhere in the world, again, with no KYC, you can send and receive your Bitcoin Cash tokens just as easily as you can with Bitcoin Cash directly. But now anybody can pay dividends to those token holders in Bitcoin Cash or any Bitcoin Cash token. So basically, historically, anonymous bearer shares have existed, or dividend payments have existed, but you've never, ever, ever had anonymous bearer shares that are able to receive dividend payments. And now that exists on the Bitcoin Cash network. And I think we're going to see more and more businesses around the world start to use this amazing platform to pay dividends to anonymous bearer share token holders. Like, this is a really, really big deal. I think we're going to see more and more people use it for all sorts of interesting things.
Oh, man. I mean, people, I think, have the notion that for the most part, Bitcoin or cryptocurrencies had been developed. The truth is, there is so much just in the three things that you've named in the past 10 minutes that are just extraordinary, groundbreaking experiences, especially for people. Like I said, there's people don't take into account that there's a huge portion on this planet of people that do not have credit cards and bank accounts and sometimes even identification, driver's licenses. So the whole notion of this leaves them completely out of the Bitcoin Know Your Client. So what you're speaking of is the inclusion of, and it's beautiful, of this large portion of people.
Yeah, Bitcoin Cash works right now today for everyone on the entire planet. Whether they're earning a dollar a day or $1 million a day, Bitcoin Cash works for them right now today and is useful to them in their lives.
Now, Roger, normally currencies are considered to be investment opportunities. Gold and silver, which have been used as a medium of exchange, as money and vehicles for investors to bet on and hedge against negative interest rates or inflation or some sort of crisis. Investors cite the intrinsic value of precious metals and their acceptance. What is the potential here in this space?
So I think anybody that cites the intrinsic value of anything hasn't thought it through clearly enough. So lots of people love to say gold has intrinsic value. And I'm a big gold fan. I was a gold bug before the invention of Bitcoin. But gold has no intrinsic value. The value is in the mind of the person beholding it. So an interesting thought experiment on this. You know, there's lots of gold in the world today, and it's worth lots of, you know, dollars or euros or yen. But imagine a world in which there were no human beings on the planet. Would the gold have any value? And I think pretty clearly the answer is no. So the gold only has value because us human beings are here to give it the value in our mind, because we're going to use it for other things. So gold has no intrinsic value, and Bitcoin has no intrinsic value. The value is in the mind of the person that's going to be using it for something or other. And gold is useful for all sorts of things. It's useful in dentistry and jewelry and electronics. Bitcoin is useful in all sorts of things as well. And so the value isn't in the object itself. The value is in the mind of the person using that object. And I think Bitcoin Cash and cryptocurrencies in general have a huge amount of value because people can use it to make anonymous bearer shares and pay dividends. They can use it to transport value from one part of the world to another without having to get permission from banks or governments or corporations. And it does all sorts of amazing things for people all over the world. But the argument that gold has intrinsic value and Bitcoin doesn't, I think it's from people that just haven't thought it through enough.
Exactly. Now, you certainly went all in with your instincts very early in this sector, and it's been phenomenal for you. Now, the ascent of the price from pennies to $10,000 is probably the most significant in history. So stepping back outside of yourself for a moment, if Roger Ver were to be seeing cryptocurrencies for the first time today, what would your perspective be? Are you betting big on more gains from where we stand right now?
I think you need to look at the cryptocurrencies and figure out which ones are going to be the most useful to the most number of people in actual commerce, and then buy some of those. And I think the two that are the most likely to get the most adoption in actual commerce at this point are Bitcoin Cash and probably Ethereum after that. With Bitcoin having it has a big network effect, but it has a horrible user experience. And I'm not bullish on that as an investor at all. Any wise investor diversifies, so hold a nice, assorted basket of cryptocurrencies if you're going to invest in the space. And I invite people, understand what you're investing in, try it out, make a wallet, send and receive some of them, to and from, you or yourself or your spouse or your kids or whoever. Know what it is you're investing in. Don't just go in blindly. And Bitcoin Cash, you'll see it has the best user experience with the most user-friendly wallet. It literally takes longer to download the Bitcoin.com wallet than it does to start using it. It's so amazingly easy and fast. And I set up more people with wallets than I can count today in Switzerland. And they were all like, that's it? That's all you have to do? There's got to be more. Why didn't you ask for my name? Why didn't you ask for my email? I'm like, no. This is peer-to-peer electronic cash for everybody. There's no sign-up process. There's no anything. You just download the app and you're good to go. And it doesn't matter how old or young you are or what color you are or what color your passport is. It works for everybody right now today. And there's no other cryptocurrency that can give that good of a user experience
right
today. Now, and I hope, I should add one more caveat. I hope something even better than Bitcoin Cash comes along, because then I'll be right here on your show promoting that one. Because just like I hope something better than my new iPhone comes along, so I get to use that, I hope something even better than Bitcoin Cash comes along, so I get to use that. That's how the world moves forward, is by inventing new and better things that people get to use.
Yeah, this is so exciting. Now, for people, and believe it or not, the majority of our people, even in our audience, still don't have, even though they know a lot about cryptocurrencies, they haven't taken the plunge. Now, if someone were to go to Bitcoin.com right now, brand new, walk us through the steps for everybody.
So the first site they should probably visit is free.bitcoin.com, and we're giving away about a nickel's worth of Bitcoin Cash to anybody that goes over there and downloads the wallet. And again, free, just like that, free.bitcoin.com, and you can see the magic of it in action. It'll go from our server right there to your phone or right there to your computer. You don't have to give your name. You don't have to give for the free.bitcoin.com, there's a little bit of a check to make sure you're not the same person over and over asking for a nickel. So for that one, you technically have to give an email address to verify it, but it can be any throwaway email address. It doesn't have to be your main email address. But then from there, you can head on over to the local.bitcoin.com and find someone near you that'll buy or sell Bitcoin Cash with you. And I invite you to join your local city's Bitcoin Cash meetup group. There's Bitcoin Cash meetup groups all across the world. So if you're living in any major city, there's already a Bitcoin Cash meetup group where you're at. And you can go and find other people that are very knowledgeable about this and will guide you through the whole process and show you how to work it. And in fact, if you happen to be in Zurich, Switzerland, tomorrow night we're having a Bitcoin Cash meetup here at a restaurant that's accepting Bitcoin Cash. The only cryptocurrency they're accepting is Bitcoin Cash because it works so well. And if you own a business and you want to start accepting cryptocurrencies, check out our Bitcoin Cash Register app. You can start accepting Bitcoin Cash right now today at your business with no sign up required. Again, it's called the Bitcoin Cash Register app. So it's like a cash register for Bitcoin Cash. It's amazing how many shops all over the world are using that now as well.
Amazing. So definitely go to Bitcoin.com, explore everything Roger's talking about, and then go through the steps. One more time. It's free.bitcoin.com. Wow. And you get what? Say it one more time.
You'll get about a nickel's worth of Bitcoin Cash for free. But today it's worth about a nickel, 5 cents. But in the future, it might become worth as much as, you know, 50 cents or even a dollar. So you never know. But it'll start you down the path to understanding and using and being a knowledgeable person about cryptocurrencies. And that's how I got my first Bitcoin ever. It was a free website on the internet run by Gavin Andreessen. It was giving out a little bit of Bitcoin Cash. It was worth, you know, maybe 5 or 10 cents as well at the time. And I went and got my first Bitcoin at that point, which still has the same characteristics as Bitcoin Cash today. And here I am today, about 9 years later, still heavily involved in the space because it was so exciting. So now it's you know, everybody else's chance to get started at free.bitcoin.com.
Beautiful. That is extraordinary. No one has any excuse not to own any. Get your foot in the door. Get your toe in the door. Roger, thank you so much for coming on this show today. How can everybody follow you, your thoughts, and also talk about your website just a little bit before we go?
Yep, the best way to follow me and what I'm up to is at bitcoin.com. We have everything. We have an exchange. We have a local marketplace. We have a forum. We have all the latest news at news.bitcoin.com. We have a free wallet. We have absolutely everything you need to learn all about not just the current state of the Bitcoin Cash and Bitcoin ecosystem, but the entire history to how we got here today. And if you know the history of how we got to where we are today, you have a much better chance of being able to successfully predict the future of where we're going. And so I invite everybody to visit Bitcoin.com, and you're welcome to follow me on Twitter at Roger K. Veer as well.
Awesome. Give us a little nutshell, just a 3 or 4 seconds of, or sentences really, of how we got here. Just how would you nutshell our history?
I think it's been going on for myself, it was from reading science fiction books as a kid. So the science fiction authors were writing about the future in which we have cyber cash and people can send and receive money on the internet with anybody. Well, with the invention of Bitcoin, it came into existence. And now there's several thousand different cryptocurrencies that are all competing for market share within this entire new realm that's being developed. So I think read more books about everything. Reading a book is like sitting down with one of these really knowledgeable people and they can just send you all their information right there. So get started today at Bitcoin.com. We have lots of book recommendations on Bitcoin.com as well.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Roger, for coming on this show today.
Thank you, Michelle. I look forward to the next time.
Absolutely. Mr. Roger Veer, CEO of Bitcoin.com. For Cryptocurrencies, the Future of Digital Money Show, I'm Michelle Holliday at PortfolioWealthGlobal.com.